Alright, so, in case you haven't noticed,
something on your mind?
I have tried to stay quiet during dialogue sections. However, due to me being really ADHD, I just get bored. You feel me? But, yeah. And if you haven't noticed, I'm using a, female character, as opposed to my other male characters, and that's because I wanted to try out, some animations for women in the base game.
My legs are begging for a rest.
Okay, so you say stuff. Oh, you're tall. You're very tall. You got a head on me. But, yeah, and so I made this character the other day to test out the mods, and I've just gotten kind of attached and just decided to play through the mod with this. I might not use her for other mods if I decide to do so, or I might. Who knows? So, what do we have to do now? Investigate Arnima through speaking with Jackos. Let's get going, boys. Back to the road. Actually, let's go to the inn. There's someone's house. There's gotta be a tavern in somewhere. Or I could just wait, but I don't really like waiting all that much, but whatever. I prefer get a well-rested bonus. But I can't find the end.
I could go for a point like that now. Come on, what you say?
Point into the end, dude. B&B wants you too. I don't know why it wouldn't, but you never come. Alright, is there a road that I could follow? Because we're going over here. I hope there's a road. Unless it's on the other side of town. It looks like it is. Okay, we gotta go back. Made by the same people who made Neon Skyrim Firma, or whatever it's called. And I love that mod. I'm probably gonna play it through this channel. Because it is a fantastic mod. But this mod is very reminiscent of Falskar, which is another big DLC size. Just, it is great mod. Perfect voice acting. Voice acting in this is great. Woman in there who I was talking to actually has the. Oh my god, look at all this. This is beautiful, dude. Looks like that's that was great looking. Some witch men. Steven. No.
I see you,
stop. Ow. That hurt.
Say your prayers. Hit me, and I'll put you on your ass.
I'm unsure on how big the map is, because this might seem pretty big, but what this game does, with DLCs and mods, is that they make the maps much bigger than they actually are. Which is what they did for the Dragonborn DLC, it's what they did for the guards talked of a nearby storm, experienced calamity from the sun. does look like this mod is doing that, but I prefer substance over size. Personally. Because I'd rather a whole bunch of things to do in kind of a smallish map than a really large map with not a whole lot of things. It does look like this mod has a whole lot of
this type of power.
So, what I like about this guy so far is that he does have things to say and remarks to make. He's not just being quiet and just killing stuff for me. So that's pretty dope. There's like a valley or something right here. I hear. Damage health. Yes, now make poison. And what I like about this mod is how it's compatible with other mods that aren't usually compatible with new areas of the game, like Frostfall, which is that blue meter in the top right corner and in the top right corner. Top of my
screen. Shoot him down. Kill this bastard already.
Come here. So yeah, I didn't expect that mod to work. My meter would just tell you down the entire game, but it is good to know that I can die of hypothermia in this mod, so. And we'll probably do that side quest in that town later. Is that plan to hopefully play through this mod? Oh, we got some dead witchmen. We actually went through the effort of adding a new fauna to the game. That's pretty sick. Oh, doesn't this look ominous? Here later. two things you're gonna hear me say a lot. see that wyvern that we saw earlier and we're talking to him. Why are you in the air?
Will. The taxes, sir, they are too great for what we produce.
Can
you be so merciful to have the lord of this?
You know I had to. Come on now. Orland, that sounds familiar.
It's like a town. Take up the sword. What else can you do except take up the rake?
Get much use outside of the odd guard who's just entered his helmet. That Brennan up in the divide steals all my business. I can't hate him though. His skills with the hammer are extraordinary. As for your question, sure, take as long as you need.
Yeah, they're even doing voice acting for that is fantastic. I love to see that. They probably have more voice actors than the actual.
Greetings, sister. You look weary. I have something to help you relax.
Oh,
if you're interested.
Hey, this is the drug dealer. Hello, guards. And the guards look sick, too.
You alright?
Y'all just gonna let me in? I. That's cool. And I haven't crashed
you
at all yet.
You can't keep it all. That's my earnings for the season. Listen, I can treat you lads to a round at the inn if you just let me take back half my stuff. A good compromise, right, boys?
It's always Evermore. Never us that you care about. Why is that, merchant? Gold more important than blood, huh? And nah, we're keeping the whole lot of it. Besides, the inn stopped selling quality ale a good while ago. Nothing but piss pints now.
Too right. Been ages since we've had a good drink. Probably buy a whole fortnight's worth of rum on your behalf, merchant.
Fortnight?
Those punces at Evermore will have to wait for their next.
What's the matter?
Still gonna forget.
You're here. Now, we're a generous lot. So your horse and whatever rags you wrapped in are all yours. And this is only temporary, so don't feel too glum.
Did you get your
Yeah,
pride?
Bugger off before we get old Morty involved.
Word spreads, lads. We'll be surprised. When aren't we merchants in trouble with this humble lot? They've got this racket going where they take our goods for inspection, but really we know they're just pinching whatever they find that can fetch a good price.
That's not fair.
I do really need my goods, but I know that they'll give me hell if they find out I'm causing more of a hassle than I've done in the past.
Do some good.
All right, they'll tread with care. Don't tell them it was me who sent you. Just say you oversaw the entire thing and decided to be the gentleman when these prats were locked. Cheers, friend.
Spit it out.
What are you, his lover? We're just assessing any item that may be sold as munition for our enemies. The rest of it may be distributed to the people of Arnima to help with their suffering. We're doing a good thing. What succubus did you have to kill for that magic
tongue?
All right, tell the merchant to grab his stuff. God knows this town doesn't need any more enemies.
My speech skill isn't even that high.
Wait, let me see your neck. Nah, not an exile. A mercenary then. Same type of scum. Really want to earn your coin? Then try the cemetery just north of the town. Undertaker been having problems.
I love talking to your back.
Another day in the reach.
Alright.
Don't cause any trouble now.
Okay.
Get on with it.
Is that hanging? No, it's beheading.
Another gutter rat.
Silence, criminal. You die as you lived.
So they're gonna behead him for stealing. It's kind of like, you know, the Middle East or something. Oh. There's his head.
I can't stay here.
Seem like a very friendly or progressive town or city in any sense. Those two words. I love towns where you just walk in and cuddle. Alright, hello.
An eager helper or a plotting saboteur? If the latter, then I must warn you, there's no second chances within this town.
I noticed.
First sign of you turning cloak will have you hoisted in the dungeon.
We're beheaded.
What do you suggest? Confront our foes with daisies and smiles? They'll cleave your smug face in two. Yeah, there's some truth to your words. And I'd be remiss of this town's welfare if I stubbornly defend my stance. So if you're sincere and you want to help out, then we have a job at hand.
Don't worry, I'm a helper.
Oh no, Frank. Not attempt, but do. This isn't a job that you can just half-ass and make your peace with the land. You'll have to stick it through, else Mara's going to be receiving another soul. If you haven't noticed, we civilized folk in our civilized gatherings are but an enclave to all the scum that lie in wait, just a stone's throw from our gates. Our closest neighbors happen to be those feral folk dejected from the kingdom's settlements, making the wilds their home. Exiles. Same thing, just different legal repercussions if they ever return to where they were booted. The punishment here is death. Mortifane decreed it so. Even the family of exiles can expect the same harsh treatment if they're ever found to be consorting with their criminal kin.
Now that's guilty by association. That's not fair.
Well, we needed a scout to oversee any contraband smuggling or corruption within our ranks. We may be dealing with the delinquents. The exiles don't pose the same threat as all the other villains in the Reach, but they sure break cohesion here in the kingdom. Always had a problem with our guard, doped up and turning a blind eye to their duties. Sometimes it's hard to distinguish between your own and those rats who supply them.
Got it. Tell me where to go.
Just what I like to hear. Some conviction for your work. Here, give us your map.
First,
I'll dot the area that our scouts use as a vantage point.
Good, but not the second one.
Can gander at the whole camp on this humble knoll. Just make sure you're discreet with this venture. These exiles may be dumb, but they ain't blind.
Wasn't a good movie. Just drinking some water. Gotta stay hydrated. Lest I contract corona.
Never seen you before, so I'll hazard a guess that you're new. The sheer state this town must be in for a newcomer to first remark on its poverty. If you're willing to stay a while longer, then you'll come to witness that some of us still retain our civility.
Among other things.
Don't judge a book by its cover, they say. Wish that were completely true in our case.
I hear this may be the Lord's doing.
And I hear you can get your tongue cut off for having your words stray so close to treason. Now, there's no point in scaring off another visitor, and I should applaud you for that intuition. Many have come to stay in this tragic town, only bemoan the people. Instead of looking to who governs them.
Give you 500 gold, and all you do is cut.
Got ourselves a spy.
Why using that axe? Just use the one on the on your back.
Yeah, I know who you're talking of. Tell her that a helping hand is more than welcome. She'll get the gist. Before I forget myself as someone of meager authority, take this letter as well. The seal is meant to keep prying fingers out, so she'll know if you start sticking your nose in. What? Want to take me to dinner? Just make sure you get back to her safely. If you ever feel your safety compromised, make sure to leave no trace of that letter.
You got it, Chief.
That's all the blood that follows will be on your hands, not mine.
Alright, so,
get out of this old dumpy town.
I've probably been recording for like an hour and a half or so, and I'm gonna cut all that up into different episodes, so... But for now, I'm gonna stop recording, because I don't want the file getting too large and literally impossible to upload. So, I'll see y'all when I continue, probably tomorrow, or something like that. I'll just keep making parts. I'm not gonna upload an hour and a half footage. Chop it all up, and we'll do Red Dawn, and then we'll return, and probably From Dusk and stuff like that. And, thank you for watching all these parts if you've gotten this far. I bid you good day.